son who's out there. DUIs, domestic violences, guns pointed at my head, in all the wrong situations. But God said, you know what? I'm going to use the foolish things of this world. I'm going to use you, Andrew, to say, you know what? Go out to the Walmarts. Go out to the four corners of this world and preach the gospel of Jesus Christ, because he loves you so much that he sent his only begotten son to die on the cross. That if you believe and accept him into your heart, that you too, when you pass on, that you will see eternity in heaven, that you will not perish and go into the fiery flames of hell. As a messenger of Jesus Christ, I love you guys. And if you repeat this prayer after me, if you repeat this prayer after me and say it with all your might and believe it, that Jesus Christ will enter into your heart and enter into your life, and he will set you free from any addiction, any health issue. But you have to believe it. You can't just say a prayer and say, you know what, I just want these guys to shut up. But I want to say this prayer because, God, prove yourself real to me. Just like he did to me. I was sitting in a church on a Sunday morning, and I said, God, I don't want to change my ways. I'm just going to sit here because I want to be around like-minded people that don't do the things that I did in secret. But I came and I sat in the pew on a Sunday morning, and God said, stand up during this worship song. Stand up. You don't have to clap your hands. You don't have to worship to this music. Just stand up. And let me tell you one thing. I obeyed the voice of God that morning. And let me tell you one thing. A sudden wind bled into me, and it was the Holy Spirit. And the Holy Spirit is here, and he is alive, and he is active. And he's saying, son, he's saying, daughter, he's saying, friend, give your life to me. And as I stood up, I felt the presence of God entering me, and I felt my body begin to just feel like no other. It was better than any drug that could give me that feeling. There was no alcohol that could give me that feeling, but it's only God that can fill the void in your life. That is the only person. God bless you. Jesus Christ loves you, and he wants to give you this opportunity to say, you know what, even if you don't come up to us, even if you say, you know what, I don't need nobody to see, you don't need anybody to see you say this prayer, as long as it's between you and God, because the God that we serve, it's a relationship, just like you have with your spouse, just like you have with your children. Just because we cannot see God right here, right now, does not mean that he does not exist, because he does. You are living proof. When you woke up this morning and your eyes opened, when you got up and your two feet began to walk, when you got up and you had breath in your lungs, that is the God. He woke you up. He could have took you out. But let me tell you one thing. He's given you an opportunity to give your life over to God. You did not create yourself. God created you. God created the person that brought you into this world, and so on, so forth. But let me tell you one thing, that I'm a living example of the love of Jesus Christ that gave me another shot. He said, I'm going to give you a second shot to say to the people that he loves you. He changed me, and he can change you too. Maybe you're stuck in your pride. Maybe your pride is all the way down your throat. You can't say, you don't want to give those terms up. You don't want to give the lifestyle. You don't want to give up the alcohol. You don't want to give up the drugs. You don't want to give up the party. But let me tell you one thing. You don't have to. Because when you give God a try, he will take all those desires away from you, and he will get you to living a righteous life. Now, brothers and sisters, if you repeat this prayer after me and you accept God into your heart,